Let's see your math, chapter 10, question number 38. The pulley swan has a radius of 10 cm and moment of inertia 0.5 kgm² about its axis. Assuming the inclined planes to be frictionless, calculate the acceleration of the 4 kg block. Let us denote 4 kg block by m1, 2 kg block by m2, radius of the pulley by r, moment of inertia of the pulley by I, and the elevation of the incline by theta. Let the acceleration of the 4 kg block be a. Since the 2 kg block is connected to the 4 kg block directly through the string, 2 kg block will move exactly as much as 4 kg block moves. Thus, acceleration of 2 kg block is also a. Also, if the angular acceleration of the pulley be alpha, then a must be equal to alpha r. If you do not know the relation between angular acceleration and the linear acceleration, you may watch our video explaining this relation. The link for the video is shown on the screen and given in the descriptions below. From this relation, we get alpha is equal to a by r. Finally, let us assume the tension in the segment of the string between the pulley and the 4 kg block be T1, while in the segment between 2 kg block and the pulley be T2. Now let us draw the free body diagram of the 4 kg block. Gravitational force of mg acts in downward direction. The component of the gravity along the incline is m1g sin theta and perpendicular to the incline is m1g cos theta. Tension T1 is pulling it up the incline, normal contact force acts perpendicular to the incline and the block is moving down the incline with acceleration a. Writing the equation of motion along the incline, we get m1g sin theta minus T1 is equal to m1a. In the free body diagram of the 2 kg block, gravitational force of m2g acts in vertically downward direction whose component along the incline is m2g sin theta and perpendicular to the incline is m2g cos theta. Tension T2 is pulling the block up the incline and normal contact force from the incline acts perpendicular to the surface. The block is moving up along the incline with acceleration a. Writing the equation of motion along the incline, we get T2 minus m2g sin theta is equal to m2a. Finally, let us draw the free body diagram of the pulley. Tension T1 pulls it down the incline on the right while T2 pulls it down the incline on the left. The pulley is rotating in clockwise direction with angular acceleration alpha, which is equal to a by r. Since the radius of the pulley is r, torque due to T1 about the axis of pulley is T1 into r in clockwise direction, while the torque due to T2 is T2 into r in anticlockwise direction. Thus, the net torque is T1 into r minus T2 into r in clockwise direction, which must be equal to I into a by r. If you do not know how to calculate the torque, you may watch our video on calculation of torque. The link for the video is shown on the screen and given in the descriptions below. Simplifying the equation, we get T1 minus T2 is equal to I into a by r square. Adding all these equations and simplifying, we get m1g sin theta minus m2g sin theta is equal to m1a plus m2a plus ia by r square. Putting the values, we get 2 root 2g minus root 2g is equal to 4a plus 2a plus 0.5a by 0.01. Simplifying, we get root 2g is equal to 56a or a is equal to root 2g divided by 56. Simplifying, we get a is equal to 0.25 meter per second square. This is our answer. In order to request solution to any question from SC Verma book, post the question number and chapter number in comments below. Like and share the video to help other students find us. Subscribe the channel, like our Facebook page and follow us on Twitter for latest updates. Thank you for watching.